Good evening, everyone. I'm Wu Fei.
Hi, I'm Shanir Blumenkranz.
Thank you for tuning in for tonight's show, and we're very excited. Hope you enjoy it.
Yay!
Good evening. Thank you for coming out in this drizzling, rainy Thursday night. We're really happy to see everyone here. My name is Meng Tongguan. I'm a senior producer here at Lincoln Center in the programming department. Welcome, welcome. Here at Lincoln Center in the David Rubenstein atrium, we have 3 to 4 free programs every week. We're really happy to see you guys here. Can I see a show of hands who is the first time that you are coming here? Oh, wow, we have so many. Thank you. And I'm going to ask for a show of hand on the Zoom, not Zoom, YouTube and Facebook live streaming. If anyone's first time looking, we won't be able to see, but really, thank you for doing this concert with us. So today, we are really honored and glad that we have invited Wu Fei and Shanir Blumenkranz to perform here. Sorry, Shanir Blumenkranz to perform here with us with guzheng, a zither instrument, very popular in China, and a wood instrument. I'm pretty sure they'll introduce the instruments much better than I do, so I'm going to turn the stage for them.
Shh. Thank you.
Thank you, Meng Tong. Thank you, Godfrey. Thank you, Manifa. And thank all the team, Spencer. Light engineer, sorry, I forgot your name. And so many names to remember. And most importantly, Shanir. I love playing with him. So, dream coming true. If you haven't seen the instruments, just a quick brief intro. It's called a guzheng. Gu in Chinese means ancient. Zheng is zither. So literally it means ancient zither. With about at least 2,600 years of history, it's been around. What you are looking at is the most standard modern guzheng. That's actually the product of after 1960s because it had a lot of development. Added to strings and steel wire inside, a nylon coat outside, and covers four octaves. So it has a wide range, so it could really play almost like a piano. The modern score is just a piano score, left hand, right hand, bass clef, treble clef. And then, so that's my instrument, and I'm Wu Fei, sorry, like reverse order. My name is Wu Fei. And so what Shanir has played. Shanir, would you tell us about it? The first instrument you played was the oud.
The oud?
The oud, yeah.
Yeah.
It's a traditional ancient lute from the Middle East. How many strings?
11 strings.
Did you hear 11 strings? Yeah. I think it has at least 3,500 years of history. I thought mine was old. I'm just like a teenager. I got another 1,000 years to come.
And then the gimbri is from North Africa. Yes. And has three strings and is tuned in GDG or DGD. DGD. Yeah. And then it's very percussive.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's a camel. It's a drum.
Oh, it's a drum.
Yeah.
Is this a camel skin?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow. That gives me an idea. Ooh. Maybe I'll add some rings. Like we... And so that's we're very happy, so happy to see old friends and new friends, and it's just been such a wonderful night opportunity to share the music we create, and we love making music with each other. All right, and then, oh yeah, so I'm going to play a traditional repertoire piece. So now you see this little, my little compartment is the modern guzheng, which I can use a tuning hammer. It's the same size as the piano hammer, tuning hammer, and quickly change to a different scale. So I lower G to F sharp, and instantly I have a D pentatonic, from G pentatonic to D pentatonic. Next piece I'd like to play is from the Shandong school, because since the history of the instrument is so long, there has been at least six major schools of styles of playing throughout China, and this is from the school from Shandong, and there is a Chaozhou school in Guangdong province. There's another school in Guangdong province, the Hakka school, and then there is the Shanxi school, and then the Zhejiang school in the east coast, and then the Henan school in the central. So they all have very specific way of playing, and it's been like that for many, many centuries. So the one that I'll be playing is quite a famous piece called the Yu Zhou Changman, Fisherman Song at Dusk. So it's from one of the representative pieces from the Shandong school. Thank you. Shandong province had quite a, almost the birth of the deep tradition of Chinese civilization, where Confucius was born there. The author Pu Songling was born there. He wrote the immortal ghost story. There was a lot of very, kind of like a Midwest a little bit, the culture. I mean, not the culture, but have a lot of cornfield. However, it's also a lot of famous philosophers were from that province. Okay. When I was in graduate school at Mills College in California, I discovered prepared piano. So as a composition student, we had to learn a lot of contemporary composers, what they had been exploring on their instruments, on their way of composing. And at the same time, I was also studying playing a Balinese gamelan. So there's a lot of things all kind of came together, and I have a lot of strings. So I could do prepared guzheng as well, instead of a prepared piano. And I found all these very inexpensive gear, all keychain rings. Metal works really well. You have a lot of keys, take the keys off, and then just add them. And then all of a sudden, I have a set of new sounds. That's my smoke machine. Let's get in the mood. Thank you.
扁担绑在了板凳上，扁担不让扁在绑在了板凳上，扁担偏要扁担绑在了板凳上。
Touring, when I learned, I got really familiar with all the ACs in different hotels in America, because I often have to tune my guzheng in the hotel, and all the ACs are in B flat, because I have to tune A, and then my tuner just struggle when I play A, and then the AC B flat. So I thought, maybe all the AC engineers were clarinetists. So. So I'm gonna do a B flat thing with Shanir.
That's your wind.
Right. Tone colors. Sounds more like a blue and yellow to me. Ah, like that. Yes. So I have F sharp too. Yeah.
Thank you.
took me somewhere. You took me somewhere. I said, you took me somewhere.
You took me too.
Whew. What happened? I'm glad we're recording this because so much stuff, I've never done it. It was his first time. Whew. Whew. Oh, yeah, this one.
Thank you.
It's a song called Saratoga. I wrote in Saratoga, California. Yeah, right? Oh, wow, yes. It was beautiful. I was doing a residency there in Montavo Art Center. Oh, it was gorgeous. It was beautiful. Wrote that piece. And now I'd like to do a childhood folk singing, but it's not folk song, it's called a shuo chang. It literally means speaking and singing. So it's a art form, singing musical form between Chinese operas to folk songs. So usually in all over, each region has its own form. Usually it's two musicians on stage. It happens usually in tea houses in the evening. You come to have some tea before dinner, and then the two musicians will be separated with a table. And sometimes they have tea, their tea there, or have a prop, like usually a fan there. So they play, often it's a pipa, a lute, or another sanxiar, the three-string fretless lute as well. And then they play and sing at the same time to tell usually a novel, an old novel. Let's say a novel that has 80 chapters. So one chapter go on for one night. But you got to keep coming back for 80 nights to finish that. I think this is the original form of soap opera because they really stop right there. Oh, come, you want to know what's going on? Come back tomorrow night. So whole for 2 months, you finish one novel. So that's this kind of a way of, a storytelling, spoken and singing mixed together because can it be in and out because the language can be after speaking and this goes into melody naturally because it's all pitch oriented language. So naturally, if you have a lyrics, there's the old school of poetry in Chinese, 诗歌 literally means poem and song. So poems were supposed to be song because it has melodies. So this one is called the chachur, is originated from where I'm from, in Beijing area. It used to be sung by Manchurians, and it's a entertainment that from the Manchu, when they hang out and they will play this also ba jiao gu, the eight banner drum. So eight banner, each banner symbolizes the eight banners of old Qing royals. So and then they play and then just entertain themselves. So this is one of their kind of early evening, late afternoon hang. The old royals just kind of, let's just sing something. So this one is called the Han Ren Duo Kuai Le, and I translate to ignorance is bliss. So it's usually they're all ancient texts about philosophies, like way of living, way of thinking, and then this one basically is ignorance bliss. Look at all those people get struggled and stressed out about life, about all the ego's things, and I'm gonna just sit back in my jade palace, be zen and let go, and because life is just like a blink of dust in universe, and the moment that you realize everything has been gone and you are about to be gone. So it's really just chill and enjoy the moment because we're all gonna be gone. So it's much more laid back. So this one, okay, all right. Yes, I like this. Slow, but that's actually good perspective. There's another version. I can keep it. Yeah. These are all movable bridges. So when I move them to do fine tuning. And I wear finger picks. I call them my claws. Piece I like to play is a actually contemporary piece. It was arranged by two composers in 1981 by guzheng master Fan Shang'e and a Tibetan composer He Sang Deji. It's called Xue Shan Chun Xiao. It's I translated it as a Himalayan Spring. So it's basically it's based on Tibetan traditional music.
Thank you.
experiment as well. We're doing a sound check. Spencer helped us with this idea, and then I got him. Can I unplug? Sorry, I'm...
No, unplug.
Oh, right, that's right. Yeah, I don't unplug. Yeah. Change over. So I'm going to stand the guzheng up. So one day, where this idea came from is, I live in the middle of a forest, so it's very dusty. I got lazy to, you know, wipe the dust. So I started to like, start doing that, and I started hearing all these harmonics to pop out. So I kept doing it until I found the best kind of a sound when I sing inside the box, and then all the strings to start vibrating. And then I hear all the harmonics from the vibration of the string to the sound box. So I want you guys to also hear that. So we're gonna do a song. And somehow this piece likes F sharp, B, and A. Doesn't like G. So I'm gonna get the a lot of science goes into it. Usually the makers will put the seal of their names, and often with a poem to have a blessing to the piece as well. So this guzheng came from Yangzhou, city of Yangzhou, which is on the East Coast. It has had at least 800 years of history of making making the best traditional Chinese instruments, and it's had famous calligraphers, singers, and composers in the city. Very beautiful. So the makers, the craft of making zithers is also a art. So they, I have another piece that had my favorite calligrapher's handwriting carved into it, and this famous bamboo and stone piece also carved on the side. And then the character, Tian Yun, means Tian is sky, Yun is the word that has sound, melody, rhythm, timbre, everything in one. So this piece shall produce all the sounds under sky, between sky and earth. So that's the blessing. We did all right, right? Ooh.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, and then thank you. Thank you all very much again. And then this last one is, this is gonna be the last song called The Little Tree. I wrote it many years ago. Dedicate this song to all the loved ones that are already gone. That was when I wrote this song, but dedicated to special ones who are not with us anymore.
Thank you.
Shanir Blumenkranz.